what you have is you have someone with a prior relationship, two individuals with a prior relationship that were involved in a domestic dispute.
Hamilton says this shooting, 37-year-old Shane Raymond grabbed the ex-girlfriend and took off. Hamilton says Raymond is white, blonde hair, blue eyes, 6'1", 235 pounds. Hamilton says four others, including three women, may have also been involved in the kidnapping. LA County health officials say salt and pepper shakers will come out of hiding on June 15th.
Along with ketchup and mustard bottles and other condiments, County Health Officer Dr. Muntu Davis says restaurants will be allowed to resume regular service for the most part.
With the exception of the mega events and the specific protocols mentioned around youth settings, as well as healthcare and congregate settings, the protocols for the sectors like the restaurant protocol will be retired.
Davis says the county will follow state health recommendations, which will also include a return to reusing one's soda cup or coffee cup at a convenience store or restaurant. Steve Gregory, KFI News.
The Justice Department says American cyber cops have taken back most of the Bitcoin ransom paid to the Russian hacker group DarkSide when it infiltrated the computer network of Colonial Pipeline. Cybersecurity expert Scott Spiro says enforcement by the U.S. might send a message to would-be hackers.
I don't know if it will deter them, unfortunately, but I think it will cause them to pause and think of what their next steps might be.
The CEO of Colonial Pipeline is expected to give more details about his company's response to the ransomware attack when he appears at a congressional committee hearing today. And fans of the wizarding world of Harry Potter can now feel the magic at a new store in New York City. Warner Brothers says the store is the largest ever collection of Harry Potter items. There are 15 themed areas, food items including butterbeer, a photo booth, and virtual reality experiences. We've got a wreck on the 118.
It's in Porter Ranch on the 118 westbound before Tampa. Wreck here takes away the left lane. They expect that volume to begin right around Reseda Boulevard. KFI in the Sky is sponsored by injury attorney SuperwomanSuperLawyer.com. Jeff Baugh, more on the 91.
Kind of a problem that's still unfolding here. This is on the westbound Artesia Freeway, kind of a halfway point between the I-5 and the 605. It's that where Artesia Boulevard crosses over the 91 at Carbonita. Now, the two right lanes and a collector lane, they're still shut down. It's an earlier crash. They're trying to get it out of your way, but it looks kind of complicated to me. There's a lot of activity down there. The backup is through Beach Boulevard. That's almost the 5. So, again, it depends where you are, but Fullerton or Buena Park, any of that, use Artesia Boulevard. If you get on the West 91 at Artesia Boulevard, there's an on-ramp there. It's pretty much full sail over towards the 605 and 710, just morning drive slow. The eastbound side's looking pretty good. No problems there. Injured in an accident, visit SuperwomanSuperLawyer.com. Jeff Baugh, KFI in the Sky.
Still some activity in Diamond Bar 57 northbound at the 60, where a car went over the side here. Your drive is going to be affected right around Pathfinder. KFI in the Sky helps get you there faster. I'm Robin Beck.
If you've been injured, you've got a cause with James.
Do you want out of that house? Oh my gosh, the headache of moving. Maybe you inherited it. You didn't even want this problem. And now you gotta clean it, you gotta paint it, you gotta repair it, you gotta stage it.
Yeah, it's even worse if there's a time element. You have to get out of this house. What if you could do this without any of that hassle? The buyer never has to walk through your house. You could sell it without an appraisal, no commission, no fees. But what if you could get paid in cash quickly, within 10 days or less?
This sounds like a fantasy, but it's not. This is exactly what directbuyers.com will do. And right now, there's a lot of bad actors out there. Don't go to a national call center. Go to directbuyers.com. They are local. It's a family-owned business. We've met Janet and Matt, and this is the team we trust. They've been around since 1986. They truly care about their clients.
Yeah, you can talk with the owners of directbuyers.com. And listen to this. They can even give you a $15,000 cash advance prior to closing if you're going to need that. Do not sell your home until you talk to directbuyers.com and see what they can offer you. They'll give you that honest, no-obligation offer. They are not going to lowball you.
Go to directbuyers.com. That's directbuyers.com. 844-242-SELL. 844-242-SELL. Directbuyers.com.
Hey, business owners. What if you could cut all your business expenses in half? It would be amazing, right? Well, you could start by switching to Spectrum Business. When you switch, you get the best internet and phone service for half of what you're paying now. Call 888-489-2212 today, and you'll get faster internet, proven reliability, and the most value. Only with Spectrum Business. Call 888-489-2212 today. Spectrum Business. No nonsense, just business. Restrictions apply. Call for details.
Your KFI Financial Report is brought to you by Bay Alarm. The Dow is down 59, S&P down 3, NASDAQ up 35, gold is $18.89 an ounce, and oil is $68.83 a barrel.
The KFI Money Report is brought to you by Bay Alarm, now offering virtual security consultations using your mobile phone. Visit bayalarm.com to get protected today.
Partly cloudy today, highs will be in the mid-60s to the mid-70s, more sunshine tomorrow, and a little bit warmer, even warmer by Thursday. Friday, highs should be back in the upper 80s, and we could see around 100 degrees by next week. Right now, it's 59 in Brea and in Pasadena, 56 in Dana Point, 58 in Pacoima. We lead local, live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. I'm Jennifer Jones-Lee.
Radio app.
If you're listening from a tent on Venice Beach, get your stuff together because LA County Sheriff's deputies will be on Venice Beach this morning trying to clear the boardwalk area of homeless encampments. We've talked about the escalation of violence among the homeless in Venice, about residents saying that they can't go out after dark. Looks like the Sheriff's Department is taking over the situation there. They're not putting LAPD on the spot, via Nueva is not, saying it's just been, they've been handcuffed, LAPD has, by Eric Garcetti and Mike Bonin. They haven't been able to do anything, so the sheriff says he's going to go in there.
A pretty dramatic arrest caught on video yesterday of a woman holding a 6-inch hunting knife just after Councilman Joe Buscaino wrapped up a news conference on trying to clean up the homelessness problem. Also, internationally, dozens of websites went offline briefly because of an outage at a cloud service company called Fastly. They said that things are back to normal, at least in their end of it, but there are still some sporadic disruptions. So we're talking about New York Times, CNN, Twitch, Reddit, The Guardian, the UK government homepage. All of those could not be reached.
Well, the big local news this morning, of course, we are awaiting the arraignment of the couple that shot and killed 6-year-old Aiden Laos on the 55 last month. It looks like they finally, after 2 weeks, got their monsters. Surveillance, investigation, and tips, they say, all played a part in identifying the suspects in the killing of Aiden.
We asked yesterday of Orange County District Attorney Todd Spitzer what sort of charges they would be able to put together, and he wasn't able to give us an answer yesterday because they're still working on it, but obviously his role as a district attorney is to come up with the most stringent charges that they believe they would be able to prove in court.
I've got to believe the reason that they're remaining mum about the charges, it's kind of rare that you hold a press conference to announce the arrest and the impending charges and don't get to what those will be, especially when you're announcing that the arraignment's going to be today, the following day. I've got to believe that they are going to build a second-degree murder case against the shooter and hopefully get the cooperation of the female that was in the car to help build that case and charge her with an accessory, because I don't know how you prove that she would know that he had the intent to shoot, which is what the threshold would be for charging her with murder.
One of the things we talked about yesterday was that the guy in this case apparently showed on social media pictures of guns, including one that it appeared that he was trying to put together, and we're not the only ones who saw that. Obviously, law enforcement said that he showed a knowledge and ownership of firearms through purchases that he had made, and on social media. One of the weapons that he displayed in some of the posts on his Instagram account was capable of delivering that fatal shot that one day. They're not saying exactly what weapon it was, but again, we do believe that they have the car and that they've got the weapon used in the shooting of Aiden Laos.
The comments on his social media profile are incredible. They are colorful. They are aggressive, and the majority of them, of the comments from people who have found his profile, talk about how they look forward to when he meets all his new friends in prison and what they will do to him.
And it's very colorful.
Very colorful.
You mentioned this, and I found it for you. This was DA Todd Spitzer yesterday talking about the arrests and what was going to be going forward, but also in reference to the memorial over the weekend, and yesterday was the private burial for young six-year-old Aiden.
And I know the question has been going through everybody's mind. Why is there so much community support and outpouring? I want to thank Supervisor Wagner and Supervisor Foley.
What? Are we
really
thanking supervisors?
And bringing so much attention and reward money to the table. But I really think the reason we are able to crack this case through the excellent, excellent work of the California Highway Patrol, and I want to thank Commissioner Ray and Assistant Chief Goodbrand.
Can we leave the thank yous out of press conferences when we're talking about a dead kid?
Amazing if you think about what they accomplished. But why so much interest in this little boy?
Well, because he was
a little boy. And I think I know the answer. It's because it could have happened to any one of us.
Nope, that's not it, Todd. That's not it. It's because it's a six-year-old boy who died in his mother's arms on his way to kindergarten. That's why we're all captivated. We don't care about the adults that get killed on the freeway. How much time did we spend on that car-to-car shooting on the 605 yesterday? What, 30 seconds? The little boy.
Yeah, that was an odd turn of phrase for him to use. Listen, the two people, again, are expected to be arraigned today. We should get some indication, maybe from court papers that are filed, if there's more information about how it is that they were able to find these two. I do have a question, though, and I have not even heard it. I have not heard a good answer to it. Remember, the vehicle in this case was this Volkswagen Sport Wagon. It's literally a station wagon, which is, listen, those are few and far between anyway. A white 2018 Volkswagen Golf Sport Wagon SE, they said, was recovered by the CHP on Sunday night. It was registered to the woman's parents, the driver's parents, as evidence, obviously, in a murder case. How many... Remember, they had a picture of it. Without the license plate, at least before they enhanced it, they had a picture of a 2018 or 19 Volkswagen Golf Sport Wagon SE. How many of those are there in Southern California?
Dave Coombs from ABC 7 texted me that there were very few. Very, very few. Like, you know, maybe 100 or something.
Yeah, it seems like that would have been the bigger or the easier break in the case, is just to track down each instance of those and who they're registered to. I don't know.
Here's another question. Who keeps the gun? Who keeps the gun? Say you fire into a car indiscriminately in an act of road rage, and then you learn that you are the face of the global news because you killed a little boy. Who keeps that gun? Now, they did say they recovered a weapon that was capable of firing that shot.
Yes. But
proving that was the weapon used, that's what I think they might need the female for.
What I also found out is that, at least according to the LA Daily News, these two were arrested at their apartment in Costa Mesa after authorities followed them home from a restaurant while acting on a tip. So does that mean somebody recognized them? Or maybe they saw the car that they were driving to the restaurant? I don't know. There's still a lot of questions about exactly how it fell together, but thankfully they're off the street.
All right, coming up next, we've got an update on the guy who's squatting in the L.A. County DA's office about prosecuting police officers. Tell you about that when we come back.
Gary and Shannon in for Handle today. Jennifer Jones-Lee is in the newsroom.
Major websites like YouTube, Instagram, HBO Max, and PayPal are coming back online after a temporary but massive outage hit the internet this morning. The outage is reportedly linked to the cloud platform Fastly. LA County Sheriff Ian Avuevo wants all homeless encampments gone from the Venice Boardwalk by the 4th of July. The sheriff will start sending deputies to patrol the encampments today. And Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau is planning to ease border restrictions for people fully vaccinated against COVID-19. We've got a wreck on the 91 we'll look at with EKFI in the Sky next.
Could you use a change in scenery? Why not make yours happen right at home with a quick outdoor makeover your family can enjoy for years to come? From renovating that old cracked driveway to adding an inviting new walkway or patio, you'd be amazed at how much a simple outdoor update can completely transform your outlook and your lifestyle. and Larry Green, CEO of System Pavers, America's number one designer and installer of elegant outdoor living systems. Our Big Change sales event is going on now to help you save a bundle on your brand new view. Call 800-K004 right now to lock in exclusive low prices and special financing. From driveways, patios, synthetic turf, lighting, and more, our experts are ready to help you make a change today. Get started by calling 800-K004 and save like never before during System Pavers Big Change Sales Event. 800-PAVE004 or systempavers.com.
All orders must be placed by June 30th, and installation must commence within 60 days of sale. Financing subject to third-party approval. See website for full offer details. Contractor's license, 661-575.
Mattress Firm's best Memorial Day sale ever has been extended for a limited time. Shop and save up to $500 on top-rated mattress brands like Sealy and Sleepy. Plus, get a free adjustable base with your $6.99 mattress purchase.
SoCal weather from KFI, partly cloudy with highs mid-60s to the mid-70s. This report is brought to you by Mattress Firm. Let's look at that ride on the 91.
Well, we're looking at Corona this time on the 91 westbound just after McKinley. It's a wreck with several vehicles. Right lane is the one that's blocked. Lots of lag for your drive from Van Buren. KFI in the Sky is sponsored by entry attorney SuperwomanSuperLawyer.com. Jeff Baugh, review of another issue on the 91.
Well, I'll say with a bunch of lanes blocked. Now, we were over this just a little while ago, so I want to give you a heads up. The crash occurred. It was westbound 91, the Artesia Freeway, right around Carmenita and Artesia Boulevard. Now, when we left, we still had the two right lanes and a collector lane shut down. They were trying to get it out of your way. But the backup was, well, it was almost to the 5. It was going through Beach Boulevard at the moment. Now, again, if you're in Buena Park and you want to go west, using westbound Artesia Boulevard or even La Palma, take it over to the Norwalk area. You can get on there or Artesia Boulevard. From there, at least you got morning drive slow going over towards 710, but all lanes open. And look at the I-5 now. Once you get past the 91 and the Laundry Boulevard, from there, that whole new section all the way up to the 605, that's looking good. South 605 just real busy coming down. Carpool lane looks good. Injured in an accident, visit SuperwomanSuperLawyer.com. Jeff Fogg, KFI in the Sky.
Porter Ranch still working on the 118 westbound just before Tampa with the left lane taken away. This morning drive here from Reseda Boulevard. KFI in the Sky helps get you there faster. I'm Robin Banks.
This report is sponsored by Smart Mouth, the only 24-hour mouthwash with twice daily use. There's nothing that'll scare your hot date away faster than bad breath. Luckily, Smart Mouth mouthwash has got your back for 24 full hours with 2 rinses a day. Find Smart Mouth in the mouthwash aisle at CVS or visit smartmouth.com to find a retailer near you.
At Cedar Sinai, we're right here for Los Angeles. Here for the inpatients, the outpatients, and the new patients too. Here to educate, one question at a time. Here to innovate through research and specialized treatment. Here to help with over 2,000 community volunteers. Here to heal with more than 250 locations in Southern California. It's why we've been here for over 100 years. And it's why we're right here if you need us. Cedars-Sinai, we're right here.
I want to break free!
Ready to break free? Norwegian Cruise Line is back and sailing this summer. Get back in the Caribbean or take in the stunning sights in Europe. And with our robust health and safety program, you can cruise confidently. Book today and enjoy 30% off all cruises, free open bar, free airfare, and more. Visit ncl.com, call your travel advisor, or 1-888-NCL-CRUISE. Offer ends soon. Norwegian Cruise Line. Sail safe, feel free.
Ships registry the Bahamas and USA. Restrictions apply.
At Loan Depot, we know home means everything. As America's lender and the official mortgage provider of Major League Baseball, we provide mortgage solutions that are personalized, convenient, and fast. With rates as low as 1.75%, APR 2.157%, now may be a great time to explore your cash-out refinance options. Give us a call at 866-888-LOAN. Rate subject to change, 2.421% fee to receive a discounted rate. Offer cost information and conditions. Equal housing lender, NMLS number 174457. Licensed in all 50 states.
Hey, California, did you hear about the big vaccine incentives program? You Call the Shot California gets $50 incentive cards for things like groceries or shopping at your favorite small business to the next 2 million Californians who begin and complete their vaccination against COVID-19. Make that vaccine appointment today at myturn.ca.gov or call 833-422-4255. Get vax for the win, people. It's a win-win for you and California. Vaccinated Californians ages 12 and up are eligible. Visit COVID-19.ca.gov to learn more.
Are you worried about refinancing your mortgage only to find a better rate later? Introducing the No Regret Refinance from Network Capital Funding Corporation. Mortgage rates are near all-time lows, and Network Capital is now offering one of our lowest 30-year fixed rates ever, 2.75% with a 2.76% APR with no points or lender fees. Incredible! Our unique process is fast, simple, and secure. And right now, the Network Capital 30-year fixed rate is 2.75% with a 2.76% APR. Now, today's low rates won't last, so talk to us about the No Regret Refinance today. Call the experts at Network Capital right now. Call 800-500-1-HIT. That's 800-500-1-HIT. As in home run. Call now and save big on your refi. 800-500-1-HIT. 800-500-1448.
NMLS ID 11712. Visit NMLSConsumerAccess.org. Licensed by the California Department of Financial Protection and Innovation under the Finance Lender Law. Number 603787. An Equal Opportunity Lender. Loan amounts $500,000 and greater. Rates subject to change. Need credit approval. Call 800-500-1448 for additional cost information.
House paint. It's a big bucket of denial. Painting over your home's exterior problems only makes things worse because beneath the new paint, your cracks are expanding, water damage is creeping up the sides of the house, and wood is rotting like bad fruit. Hi, I'm Steve, creator of Deluxe Life Coat. Unlike painters, we restore your home's exterior using our exclusive 12-step process. We water blast, repair every single crack and chip, and fix any wood rot till your house looks brand new. After we're done, you'll never have to paint your home again. That's why Deluxe Life Coat has the best lifetime warranty in the industry. It covers flaking, peeling, and yes, even cracking. What paint can say that? If paint has you in denial, you don't need a therapist. Just dial pound 250 and say Life Coat. Here's my offer. The first 10 callers today to dial pound 250 and say Life Coat will get 20% off and pay no interest for 2 years. Get in now. Dial pound 250 and say Life Coat.
Certain terms and conditions apply. CSLB number 1052855.
I'm on some email list from a realtor, and he sent 16 properties in my area and what they're selling for.
And the prices were eye-popping.
Oh, my God.
When did this happen?
I guess it happened in the last few months since the lockdown started to lift.
John and Ken.
Weekdays at 2.
I think that's what happens, the pent-up demand for people who want to move.
On KFI.
Tuesday, June 8th, in for Handel today. At the top of the hour, big day for Rich DeMuro, KTLA's tech reporter. We're going to be talking about what happened to the internet overnight. It broke. It broke for the most part. There was a bunch of websites that went offline because a cloud service company called Fastly had a problem with some of its servers and knocked some of the world's largest websites off of the air. Off of the internet, off of the wire, for several hours. They say things are back up and running, but that still means there are some sporadic outages.
Well, it looks like George Gascon is trying to pay off on a campaign promise. He wanted to go after police officers who killed unarmed people in Los Angeles County. He identified four shootings that he believes should be reviewed, including a 2015 killing of a homeless man by an LAPD officer. Former Chief Charlie Beck actually asked Jackie Lacey to file charges against this officer. And after Gascon was elected, he hired a decorated special prosecutor to review the cases.
Yeah, this guy's name is Lawrence Middleton. Here is an issue.
I find you to be a decorated special talk show host.
Well, thank you. That's very nice of you.
You're welcome.
The difference being, I am not currently serving as counsel for two defendants in three criminal cases being tried by the district attorney's office. So Lawrence Middleton, at the very least, has a little bit of conflict of interest.
You think?
Here's another wrench that's thrown into the works here. George Gascon was promising these four cases would be looked at again, right? At least two of them have already, at least in terms of manslaughter, passed the statute of limitations. So the only option, if they were to bring charges, would be a murder charge against the officers involved, which is very, very unlikely in these cases.
Middleton was among four attorneys who secured federal civil rights convictions against the LAPD officers who beat Rodney King. Get this. Get how much this guy is getting paid. Supervisors approved this, by the way. It's a four-year term for the decorated special prosecutor. $1.5 million each year.
That's pretty good. That seems like a pretty good deal for you to be paid taxpayer money.
Is that like incentivizing the green light to go after cops for shootings?
It is.
By paying him that much? Because, I mean, imagine getting paid $1.5 million every year for 4 years, and at the end of it, you're like, you know what?
I didn't find anything.
Not enough to prosecute these cops.
But thank you for my vacation house in Sun Valley. I'll think about you every time. There's only one. I said that there were two. There were three cases that went, past the statute of limitations for manslaughter. So there's only one case in which this decorated special prosecutor could consider charges beyond murder.
You've got one case to look at.
One.
For 4 years and make $1.5 million a year.
The 2018 killing of Christopher Mitchell by Torrance police. He was accused of driving a stolen car. Officers said they saw him reaching for a weapon between his legs when they shot him seated inside the vehicle. He died at the scene. Guess what? They did find a weapon. It was an airsoft rifle. But if you're there on the business end of that, chances are you don't care that it's an airsoft rifle because you don't have time to ask the guy, hey, this is funny. Does that weapon shoot actual hot lead or is it funny plastic pellets?
The Office's Justice Systems Integrity Division, which handles police shooting cases, declined to bring charges in that killing as well. So that's when Gascon decided to hire an outside attorney to review the cases, further creating war on his own DA's office.
This is an interesting, legal mental exercise, because in the state of California, there is a law against an attorney operating both as a public prosecutor, which is what the special, decorated special prosecutor would be, Lawrence Middleton, and a defense attorney within the same jurisdiction. There is a suggestion, because like I said, there is some conflict of interest. He's still serving as counsel for a couple of defendants in three criminal cases right. that are being tried by the LA County DA's office. So at the very least, there is some conflict of interest that needs to be worked out. Now, he can step down as counsel for those other cases.
There's something that smells funny with
what?
This guy.
There's something funny that smells with George Gascon? What?
Not only does this guy get $1.5 million a year, they said he could also hire outside attorneys and investigators who would work under him. Just taking a look at one case.
Yeah.
Follow the money.
Again, he has not yet signed a contract with the county, according to George Gascon, and that's because of the bureaucracy that exists within LA County, not the conflicts of interest that this guy is going to be facing once he signs that contract.
All right, coming up next, it looks like the sheriff has had it with Venice Beach. He feels that the LAPD is handcuffed because of the city leadership in terms of getting rid of the homeless encampment there that's terrifying residents. He's moving in this morning. We'll tell you all you need to know when we come back.
To the Bill Handel Show. Jennifer Jones Lee has an update.
Activists in L.A. have questioned the effectiveness of Vice President Harris's trip to Guatemala and Mexico.
The root problem's not going to be addressed at all.
Full Rights for Immigrants Coalition member John Fernandez says that root cause is a history of American meddling in the affairs of Central American countries, which he says has contributed to a pipeline of immigrants, and now he says there's been silence about a possible fix.
The U.S. Citizenship Act that Biden administration has proposed.
The legislation would offer 5 years of residency to 11 million people living in the country illegally and then a path to citizenship. In downtown L.A., Chris Ancarlo, KFI News.
The Biden administration says nearly 4,000 kids have been separated from their parents at the U.S.-Mexico border. The Family Reunification Task Force says the separations happened under former President Trump's zero-tolerance policy. It says nearly 60% of the kids are Guatemalan. News is brought to you by the Cunning Dental Group. A GoFundMe page has been set up to help the family of an L.A. County firefighter who was injured during a shooting at Fire Station 81 in Agua Dulce. Captain Arnie Sandoval is still in critical but stable condition. As of Monday, more than $42,000 had been raised. The goal is $100,000. Sandoval was shot while trying to break up an argument between firefighter Tori Carlin and the shooter, who was also a firefighter. Carlin was shot and killed. The shooter killed himself. The LA Fire Department says an early morning fire has damaged a three-story commercial building in downtown LA. LAFD spokesman David Ortiz tells KTLA five firefighters found canisters of nitrous oxide lying around the building on 3rd Street.
We have a six-story residential, elderly residential building, retirement home directly to the east, a good-sized alley in between, and that served as protection.
150 firefighters worked to put it out. The CHP says a bear has been hit and killed on a freeway in Castaic. The accident happened as the bear was crossing the 5 just before midnight last night. It was found in the center divide of the freeway. CHP says no one in the car was seriously hurt, but the vehicle has major front end damage. Authorities in dozens of countries have been secretly monitoring messages of criminals using an encrypted app developed by the FBI. Australia was part of it, and the federal police commissioner, Rhys Kershaw, says they've been using the app without the underworld knowing.
Essentially, we have been in the back pockets of organized crime and operationalized a criminal takedown like we have never seen.
800 people have been arrested, millions in cryptocurrency seized, and tons of illegal drugs have been taken in raids around the world. French President Emmanuel Macron has been slapped in the face by a man in a town in France. Macron's office says he was greeting the public when he got slapped. Macron's bodyguards pushed the guy away. Police say they've detained two people. And the last thing you want to see on a dating site is your ex.
And Tinder is helping out with a tool called Block Your Ex. The new feature helps users looking for the right one, or just one right now, to avoid that certain ex or any specific personal contact they'd rather not come across. A recent survey said close to 80% of people on Tinder would prefer not to see or be seen by an ex, while 40% say that has happened to them. Once a contact is on the no-contact list, no one will see the other, even if they're not on Tinder yet. Members who've already been using the Block tool have added, on average, 12 contacts on their list. Michael Crozier, KFI News.
Let's check out a crash on the 210.
It's going to be San Dimas on the 210 eastbound just before you get to Grand. It's the number 3 and 4 lanes that are blocked here. Car hit a deer, and that caused a chain reaction crash with several other cars. So 210 eastbound, that's going to be a struggle for you from Azusa Avenue. KFI in the Sky is sponsored by injury attorney Superwoman, Superlawyer.com. Jeff Bond looking at downtown Los Angeles.
Yeah, just want to give you a heads up now if you missed what Jennifer was trying to tell you about that fire downtown Los Angeles.
Yes.
3rd and LA Street. Fire department's still there, and I think they're going to be there for a while. The fire's out, but they got a lot of overhaul to do. So for traffic-wise, that is a problem. Again, that's 3rd and LA Street. You use San Pedro going north or south, that'll get the job done for you. Now, downtown Los Angeles in general, everybody's going there this morning. Boy, the volume is just horrific. The West End North 101 Birds, it's really something this morning. The 101 from before East LA, and then the West End coming away from Soto. Northbound, there was the almost every morning homeless encampment fire report around Silver Lake, so it's slow up that way. Southbound, pretty much Hollywood Boulevard down, even the South 5 coming out through from 110. It's slow going, but no major crashes to warn you about. Injured in an accident, visit Superwoman, Superlawyer.com. Jeff Baugh, KFI in the Sky.
You're going to find this trouble spot through Cerritos on the